Detective Story is a Japanese film released in 2007, directed by Takashi Miike. People who are fairly familiar with Asian movies will probably know just how famous this director is, as many of his films are regarded very highly by a vast majority of moviegoers. His ability to be able to create and succeed at developing a wide variety of different types of films is truly impressive. And when I say a wide variety, I'm certainly not joking. His films include the superhero flick Zebra Man, the terrifyingly creepy Audition, the bloody wild ride Ichi the Killer, the Yakuza Dead or Alive films, and the truly bizarre Visitor Q. While Detective Story certainly doesn't stand out as well as some of the director's other films, it's by no means a failure, and it has enough entertaining moments here to make it worth a viewing.
The premise of Detective Story revolves around a private detective investigating a series of murders. The victims here are all women, and after each murder, the killer removes an organ from the victim before leaving the body to be uncovered. The private detective ends up becoming a prime suspect in the bizarre string of deaths and tries to uncover the true identity of the murderer in order to clear his name. That's certainly the best way I can strip down the plot without giving anything away, which I feel is pretty important since the story itself doesn't end up being too complex. The plot should not be the reason why people watch this film, but instead it should be for the characters that they're watching on screen. The film truly shines at developing quirky characters and putting them into some really funny and bizarre scenes that definitely have a certain odd kind of entertainment value. And while the film can be entertaining, I still hear a lot of mediocre opinions about Detective Story, and I think a lot of that has to do with the fact that it can be hard for a director like Takashi Miike each and every time he directs a new movie, because as time goes by, people have more comparisons they can make to his earlier films, and essentially people are always focusing on seeing if the director can top what they've already done. And that's why I think I hear a lot of these mediocre opinions about Detective Story, because people by nature do make comparisons. But really, the bottom line here is that this is just a famous director looking to work on a certain kind of film. Here in Detective Story, it is just Takashi Miike literally working on a movie about the story of a detective, but he is able to throw in enough interesting things into the mix to create an experience that is weird, which is essentially what I consider him, you know, best known for. And he still as well is able to keep the movie in the mold of the typical detective drama. In this regard, the film is successful as it has a great deal of truly bizarre moments that really showcase the quirky characters within the story. Some of the scenes here are so weird that I think they really do lead to some very strange comedic moments. The jazz music throughout the movie really does a good job at adding to the film's weird personality and charm. I think this has a lot to do with the fact that jazz music is not commonly played in movies. This type of music only works when it is used in a film with a particular style, but I think it really does fit the bill here, and just adds another level of uniqueness to the film. For people who like to think outside of the limitations of a genre, the movie's great, but I honestly think it takes a particular person to enjoy this film. For fans of this director, the movie may not go far enough into the realm of strange. And for people who are interested in a compelling detective drama, the funny moments sprinkled within the story will perhaps take them out of the overall experience. This really does leave the film in a tough spot, because for me, it wasn't one of the best films I've seen by this director, nor did I think it was engaging enough to have a strong, lasting impression as, you know, a truly impressive detective drama. But the film was unique, and it being unique really did take it from being a mediocre film to an above-average one. This won't blow your socks off by any stretch of the imagination, and really won't impress people looking for a horror experience, but for those going into the movie with the right expectations, it certainly is a film that has some noteworthy moments. The Region 1 DVD release of Detective Story comes from Tokyo Shock. Fans of the movie will be disappointed to hear that there are no special features to speak of on the disc. We are just treated to the film itself, along with some trailers for other Tokyo Shock releases. With the movie being roughly a little over an hour and a half in length, this doesn't leave the disc with a lot of content, which means I don't think the DVD is worth picking up unless you are a pretty big fan of the film. I remember that I myself was not impressed the first time I watched Detective Story, as I thought the movie was going to be a scary film. So trust me when I say this is not a horror movie. While there may be some blood here and there within the film, there certainly aren't enough frightening death sequences or suspenseful moments for people who are expecting to come away from the experience terrified. After deciding to rewatch the film later on, I had a much better time with it, which probably had a lot to do with the fact that I knew it was a pretty standard, by-the-book detective drama with a lot of charm and personality thrown in for good measure. So when it comes right down to it, if you're the type of person who likes their movies a little strange, then I think this one is definitely worth a look. It's not an all-out bizarre experience like some of Takashi Miike's other crazy films, such as Gozu, but it never becomes boring, and I think that's what truly counts. I think it is certainly worth watching at least once.